Defeat. Soalannya ni, yang ni adalah demonstrator eh. So kita supply voltage, kemudian dia ada current, okay. Kemudian ada terhasil lah magnetic field, okay. Magnetic field yang terhasil di stator eh, di stator. Kemudian stator tu berpusing, dia berpusing anti clockwise, okay. And this is the formula, the small capital, the small n, n sing equal to 120 Fe. Fe is the operating frequency, operating frequency, and P is the number of pole. Okay, number of pole. And then so bila dia bergerak ke kiri, so dia will induce maximum voltage. Okay, at the center, kalau kita tengok, kalau kita stopkan betul-betul gambar rajah tu, dia akan menghasilkan dekat center. Okay, I think yang tentang center tu tak perlu dululah. Okay, so dia akan inducekan voltage, okay, pada rotor. Okay, so dia rotate eh. So dia rotate, kemudian rotor tu kita nampak dia bergerak ke kanan. Okay, so bila dia bergerak ke kanan, kita ada F atau V, I, satu lagi apa, B. Okay, so cuba kita gunakan Fleming hand, right hand rule. So this is F, thumb kita punya V eh, V, V. Sebab dia dia soalan dia relative motion yang bergerak ke kanan. So kanan, so current, current kita tak tahu, kita nak check current. So kita ada magnetic field. Okay, so kita nampak current dia keluar ke, kalau ke saya ni, saya nampak dia current tu keluar lah. Sekejap eh, masing-masing boleh nampak tak? Saya buka eh, slide yang pertama dulu. Macam masing-masing ni macam dah lupa kan. So formula yang dekat chapter 1 ni banyak akan digunakan eh. Wih, lambat pula ni. Ah, so dia adalah, oh, terbalik ya tadi. Okay, FBI, FBI. Okay, so bila dia rotor ni, dia relative motion ke kanan, so magnetic field ke kiri. So kita ada F, V, B atau I eh. Okay, so ni thumb is V, kita punya apa nama ni, finger ni adalah B, dan ni adalah I eh. So B dia ke atas dan dia keluar, dia keluar eh. Okay, so masing-masing boleh tengok lah. Ni kalau saya tengok macam ni lah, you boleh nampak eh. Okay, so that's why dia akan mengalirkan arus ke situ lah. So bila dia arus ke sini, kemudian dia akan rotate. Ah, kita cuba buat balik lah yang tadi. Bila dia dah ada current, kita guna pula yang left. So kita akan jumpa force dia ke kanan pula. Okay, so and then dia akan rotate same direction with the magnetic field. Okay, okay, so bila bila dia dah inducekan voltage, okay, so of course dia akan inducekan current. Okay, so as we know that current normally dia akan lag, dia akan lag lah, sebab dia ada inductance effect kan. So dia akan lag, current akan lag. So bila current when current induce, so current will induce the magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic field at the rotor. Okay, so ini kalau S ni dekat stator. Okay, stator, yang ni dekat rotor eh. Okay, so ni R ni semua R dekat rotor lah. Okay, So kemudian dia akan menghasilkan satu net. Dia seolah-olah macam menentang lah. Dia hasilkan yang satu lagi terhasil. So dia akan macam seolah-olahnya macam akan menentang. So dia akan ada satu net magnetic field. Okay. So the net magnetic field, the phase between kemudian dia akan menghasilkan induced voltage lah. Okay, and then dia punya angle in between current and also the net force is theta R. Okay, and then BR and BS rotate at end scene. When BR and BS rotate at end scene, and then rotor turns at the slower speed. Okay, so kalau dia kedua-duanya berpusing pada speed yang sama. Okay, bila dia speed yang sama, dia akan berada pada speed yang paling rendah. Rotor tu akan berpusing kepada speed yang sangat rendah, yang paling rendah. Okay, why? Nanti kita akan tengok after this. Okay, and then dia akan menghasilkan torque. Okay, daripada magnetic field stator, magnetic field stator, dia punya apa nama ni, vector dia. Okay, so vector dia akan menghasilkan induced torque. Okay, so therefore dia torque tu pun pada same direction with the magnetic field. Okay, apa yang saya sebut tadi tu boleh katakan ada dalam word-word di sini. Okay, so ada three phase stator winding is connected to the three phase supply. Current flow in the stator winding. Okay, current flow in the stator winding produce EMF. Okay, and flux density. So the stator flux density rotate at synchronous speed. So ni yang saya dah sebut tadi. And then the magnetic field passes conductors on the rotor and induce voltage in those conductor. Okay, so dia induce voltage dekat rotor lah. Since the conductor are short circuited, so current flow, current akan flow lah. Okay, so kalau kita ingat yang dalam transformer, even though voltage induced in the secondary winding, if the dia punya apa connection is apa open circuit, so current tak flow lah, tapi voltage tetap ada. So ini dia short circuit, so current boleh flow. Okay, so the rotor currents produce a second rotor magnetic field which act to oppose the stator magnetic field and also rotate at synchronous speed. So magnetic field dekat rotor, magnetic field di rotor rotate at synchronous speed. Okay, so with two magnetic field rotating at a constant speed, torque is induced. And then the rotor flux density will lag. Okay, rotor flux density will lag the stator flux density. So kalau kita tengok pun, the flux density lag current. Kalau kita tengok daripada gambar ni, so ini kan current kan. So current, kita tengok dia magnetic field yang induced tu, dia lag by 90 degree. Okay, so kalau kita tengok pun dalam macam inductor dengan kapasitor kan, so which one is lag and lead lah. So normally the inductance will lag by 90 degree lah. So flux density lag current by 90 degree. So therefore the torque will be in the same direction as the rotation of the magnetic field. The torque accelerates the rotor anti-synchronous speed is reached. Okay, rotor tu dia akan pusing. Okay, rotor akan pusing sampai dia reach synchronous speed. So synchronous speed is the speed of the magnetic field lah. Rotor stator magnetic field. So bila dia dah reach dekat synchronous speed, okay, at which time there is no relative motion. So bila dah tak ada relative motion lah. Sebab kalau ada relative motion, dia akan salah satu akan seolah-olah macam tak bergerak seolah-olahnya lah kan. Tapi kalau dulu bergerak pada direction yang sama. So bila dulu bergerak pada direction yang sama, dulu bergerak pada waktu yang sama. So tak ada relative motion. When there is no relative motion between the conductor and the stator flux density, so since the relative, then velocity become zero. Okay, bila velocity become zero, the induced voltage is zero. voltage induce zero, rotor current zero, and flux density fall to zero, and the torque also become zero. So bila zero, dia akan rotor yang tengah pusing laju tadi tu dia akan slow down lah. So, slow down balik. Okay, bila dah slow down balik, and then bila wujud balik relative motion tu, then dia akan induce balik. Okay, so lebih kurang macam itulah dia punya perjalanan untuk induction motor ni. Okay, now kita tengok dia punya slip lah. So you semua jangan risaulah. Okay, tentang induced torque ni sebenarnya ini adalah dia panggil dia punya vektor lah. Bukanlah calculation dia nilai B tu darab dengan nilai BS. BR darab BS darab K, bukan macam tu Dia vektor dia macam cross product. Okay, so basically untuk the introduction induction tu insyaAllah lah. Mudah-mudahan boleh faham. Boleh faham setakat ni?
Boleh, Doktor.
Boleh,
Boleh, Doktor.
So, jangan risau sangat lah. Nanti bila dah tengok video, tengok semula, nanti insyaAllah boleh boleh faham. So, tak ada yang nak masuk lagi. Okay, now kita tengok the concept of rotor slip. Okay, so the voltage induced in rotor bar. Okay, the voltage induced in rotor bar. Rotor tu kan ada bar yang squirrel cage kan. Yang panjang tu panggil bar lah. Depend on the speed of the rotor relative to the magnetic field. Okay. There are two terms to define the relative motion. So the first one is the slip speed. Okay. Nama dia digunakan slip speed lah. Actually there is a difference between the synchronous speed and the rotor speed. Okay. So the term is n slip. Dia nama dia n slip lah. N speed. Slip speed. So digunakan n slip equal to n synchronization asynchronize minus speed of rotor. Okay, mechanical shaft speed lah rotor tu kan. So kalau senang nak ingat, n slip adalah perbezaan dia lah. So kalau kita tengok kat sini, n sync is always bigger than nm lah. Okay, so n slip ni mestilah maximum 1 dan minimum dia mesti kosong lah, dia tak lebih daripada tu lah. Okay, so n sync tu mesti lebih laju lah daripada dia. Okay, and then the slip the relative speed expressed on PU basis. So boleh katakan dia macam boleh dikatakan macam seolah-olah calculation percentage lah, ataupun ratio So they call it as a slip. Okay, so slip is equal to the difference between n synchronized minus with the rotor speed divided with the n synchronous. Okay, so we replace the n slip with the term, the equation, and then we also can express the slip in term of the revolution radian per second. Okay, this is they call it as angular velocity kan. So angular velocity is a radian per second. Okay, so yang ni is RPM. Okay, this is the punya unit adalah RPM. Yang ni adalah rad per second lah. Okay, so yelah, kalau you susun balik, you calculate balik, you akan dapat lah dia punya calculation And then to simplify, kita boleh dapatkan from this we can measure dia punya rotor speed. Okay, so rotor speed is equal to bracket 1 minus slip times n synchronization synchronize. Okay, so from the previous equation, notice that if the rotor turns at synchronous speed, okay, so kalau rotor ni sama dengan n sync, so bila dia sama, n slip akan kosong, automatic s juga akan, so bila sini kosong, s akan jadi kosong lah. Okay, so s akan jadi kosong. So while if the rotor is static, okay, kalau dia tak bergerak, so synchronous bergerak tapi rotor tak gerak, rotor tu static. Okay, so n equal to slip, So n sin minus n m, so ni bila dia 0 and then s sama lah, dia akan jadi n sin divided by n sin lah. So become 1 eh. All motor speed fall between these two limits lah. So dia sebenarnya dia akan ada dua limit je lah. Okay, between 0 and 1 eh. So now kita tengok the electrical frequency on the rotor. So induction motor also cause a rotating transformer. Ha, so ni dia nak kaitkan lah macam mana persamaan di antara transformer dan juga induction motor. So induction motor also called as rotating transformer due to induced voltage and current. And primary, which is the stator part, so induce a voltage to a secondary. Okay, so konsep yang sama lah untuk transformer kan. So unlike transformer, frequency is not necessary same as the secondary. So apa kalau kita tengok, kita dah belajar transformer, kita tak nampak pula tentang frequency lah. Okay, dia tak macam tak ada relate lah. Okay, so at this part dia akan ada kaitan dengan frequency eh. Okay, so they say over here is if the rotor is locked, so which mean rotor tak bergerak eh. So when rotor is tak bergerak, the frequency of rotor will be equal to F stator or the operating frequency eh. And then S equal to 1 lah. So kita dah tahu tadi kan, N sin minus NM, so NM to 0. Okay, so this one at this part is NM equal to 0, so S equal to 1 lah. Okay, if rotor rotate at NM equal to N sin, so frequency rotor become 0. Okay, and S and slip also become 0. So actually semua sekali yang benda ni dia nak translate kepada equivalent circuit. So that's why dia kena tengok satu-satu dulu. So for any speed between the rotor, okay, any speed between the rotor frequency, okay, rotor frequency eh. Rotor frequency is directly proportional to the difference, okay, difference between the speed of magnetic field and sin and the speed of rotor. So boleh dikatakan semua frekuensi itu dia berkait dengan different. Okay, so bila different dia menggunakan slip. Okay, so di sini kita boleh kaitkan bahawa kita boleh lihat bahawa FR, dia tulis ya. So kita boleh tengok FR tu is equal to S FE ataupun F S stator lah. Okay, so S ni pula in between 0 to 1. Okay, so kalau dia apa nama dia tadi, kalau dia bergerak sama dia akan jadi kosong. Okay, so macam tadi yang tadi sebut kan, so bila dia bergerak sama FR equal to 0. Okay, so FE, so bila FE pula kita boleh tengok tadi kan yang N sin equal to 120 FE minus by P kan, number of pole. So dia nak FE ni lah, so therefore dia akan jadi begini lah. So dia gantikan, dia masukkan dalam FE ni lah, dia gantikan FE, dia dapat satu formula ni. Okay, so dia gantikan S tu semua, dia tolak, dia akan dapat yang ni lah, yang bawah ni. Okay, okay, so kita tengok example satu eh. Okay, so di sini they say that they have a, kejap mana example satu ni. So dia nak 220 volt 3 phase 6 pole. Okay, 6 pole 50 hertz. Okay, ni operation ni FE lah. Okay, induction motor is running at a slip 3.3 lah. So dia dah sebut lah. So S equal to 0.35 ke? Bukan kan? Eh, ni mana ni?
0.035.
Okay, sekejap. Okay. 0.035. So, ini untuk lebih memudahkan lah. Okay, dia sebut percentage. Tapi, kena ingat eh. Janganlah awak ambil S. Sekarang memang dia nak kita nak keliru kan eh. So, percentage of S equal to 3.5. S is equal to 0.035. Okay, jangan salah faham eh. The speed of the magnetic field in the revolution per second. So, kita ada formula N sin equal to 120 Fe P. So, saya rasa kita kita short kan eh. Kita take simple lah eh. Kita tak payah kira lah. Kita nak tengok formula je kan. So, ni dah boleh kira lah magnetic field in RPM. So, ni lah nanti masukkan Fe bagi 6 pole dapat lah. Okay. So, the speed of the rotor. So, dia nak kaitkan speed rotor tu. Okay. So, kita ada slip tadi kan. S N sin minus Nm N sin N sin. So ni ada, ni ada, ni ada. So kita boleh dapat lah. Okay, dia punya ni. And then slip speed of the rotor. Okay, slip speed adalah N slip equal to N sin minus Nm. Okay, so from here nanti ni dah ada, yang ni dah ada lah. Boleh dapat lah. Okay. So, and then rotor frequency in hertz. Rotor frequency. So, kita tengok tadi Fr equal to S Fe kan. Okay. So, kita ganti kan je lah. So, kita dah ada S, kita ada Fe. So, kita dapat jawapan. Okay. So, insyaAllah lah. Tak susah pun yang ni. So yang susah dia adalah kita nak gambarkan macam mana dia bergerak daripada dia statik bergerak. So bermain dengan magnetic field, kita nak imagine dia semua. Itu yang pening tu.